So this is sort of a typical scenario where we sit with a client in a client attend session and we need to nail down timing and positioning of a certain effect. And the problem is that we usually have to, you know, make some changes to the effect, you know, or if we have to make some changes to the effect, we need to go into Nuke, make the changes, start some rendering, wait for the timeline to propagate with the render, look how that looks. Maybe the client wants something, you know, that's a bit different, then go back in and, you know, it's constantly that battle with, you know, having to re-render everything. But Nuke Studio, using the GPU up node, actually allow you to do that directly in sort of real time, sitting in a timeline here, where we can instantly modify timing, positioning, and it will propagate across all the shots in real time, no problems there. And so what we have here is sort of a little effect that I created, just some fun stuff. So let's say that just as she's finished with her paint here, we could set a keyframe here, and then let's say at this point here, right here, we want the effect to sort of go up and maybe not go into the eyes here, but maybe just underneath the eyes here. And so as she's finished here, then maybe as she puts her fingers over there again, we can erode it back in like so, and maybe there. So the track was a bit fast, that's why it's sliding a bit. But it's just a proof of point. So now we have sort of modified the timing, sort of in real time. And if the client sit there and said, you know, I actually really wanted it to be on the other cheek. Well, no problem then. We can just take this, transform it across to the other cheek, and maybe rotate it a bit, like so, bam. And now we have the same effect, the same timing, but on the other cheek. And it just sticks directly inside of Nuke Studio. And so how does this work? Well, as you can see over here, this looks quite funky. So what I've done is I've actually, I need to store the UVs that are being used here to put the texture on here. And the problem is that, you know, inside of our image here, we have the red, blue, green, and the alpha channel. And that's sort of the only channels where we can store any kind of data on. We could theoretically store the UVs in just the alpha channel. The problem is that the, you know, the bit depth of the viewer here is not high enough for us to store UV positions. That would sort of cause a lot of, you know, jittering when you do like this. So what I've done is I've done a 4:2 compression where the luminance channel is stored in the red channel. In the green channel, I store the chrominance channel. So if I disable the effect here, you can see, actually I need to disable this as well, like so. So if we look at the red channel, here we have the chrominance, or the luminance that is, and in the green channel we have the chrominance. They're sort of compressed. So we have both the CB and CR stored in here. And so with the GPU up node, I decompress the 4:2, and then I have the UVs that I can then use to sample the other texture with, and that allows me to do this. So that's a really cool effect, you know, quite easy to create.